Hello everyone, welcome to Prayogik Uno channel. In this video, let's discuss about potentiometer and how to use it. In short, potentiometers are also called as POT. So this is the circuit symbol of a potentiometer. You can see that there are three pins for the potentiometer. The middle pin is called as a wiper pin. Potentiometers are available in various types and sizes. You can see here, this is one type of potentiometer which has a knob attached to it so that it's easy to adjust the values. And this type of potentiometer is called as trim pot. This is very frequently used on PCBs so that it's easy to adjust the values during production. You can see that both these potentiometers have three pins to it. As I mentioned, the center pin is called as wiper pin. Even the trim pot has three pins. Let me show you that. These are the two pins. So the pin which is single here is the wiper pin. The typical applications of these potentiometers are in volume control and on PCBs where the resistance value has to be calibrated during the production. Potentiometers can be used in two ways. One is as a variable resistor. And the other way to use it is as a voltage reference. When we will be using comparators and other circuits, potentiometers can be used to provide voltage reference. When we start building some projects, you will get to know exactly how to use the potentiometers for various applications. If we want to use the potentiometer as a variable resistor, then we need to use only two pins. You always need to use the wiper pin. So it's must to use the wiper pin when you are using it as a variable resistor. And for the other pin, you can choose any one of these. So effectively, you need to use pin number 2 or either of pin number 1 and 3. Let's go ahead and connect these two pins of the potentiometer and see how we can use it as a variable resistor. Also, notice that the potentiometers come at various resistance values. So this potentiometer has a value of 50k. So this means that the total range that this potentiometer can provide is until 50k. So it's 0 to 50k. Similarly, you can see that the value written on this trim pot is 104. So this means the value of this potentiometer is 100k. And you can vary this potentiometer from 0 to 100 kilo ohms. Now, let me place this potentiometer on the breadboard. And let me demonstrate how to use this as a variable resistance. Remember that the value of this potentiometer was 50k. So when I connect this as a variable resistance, I should be able to vary the value from 0 to 50 kilo ohms. As I mentioned earlier, in order to use the potentiometer as a variable resistor, we always need to use the wiper pin. So let me take a wire and connect the wiper pin to the pin RES in header number 4. And I'm connecting pin number 3, which is at one end of the potentiometer, to plus 5 volts. Now, let's go ahead and turn on in the Android app and observe the resistance values. Now, you can see that the resistance value is around 7.5 kilo ohms. Let me turn the knob and see how I can vary the resistance of the potentiometer. Now, as I turn the knob to one of the side, you can see how the resistance has been decreasing. Now it has decreased to around 2.6 kilo ohms. So with this potentiometer, I guess this is the minimum value which I can get. Now let me turn the knob in the other direction. Now as I'm turning the knob in the other direction, you can see how the resistance value has started to increase. So let me take it to the other end. Now it is at around 30k. Let me turn it more. So now the maximum value I'm getting is around 51 or 52k. So this is the way you can use a potentiometer as a variable resistance. Always remember, you have to use the wiper pin and any one of the pin in order to use the potentiometer as a variable resistor. Now let's see how we can use the potentiometer as a voltage reference. In order to use as a voltage reference, we need to use all the three pins of the potentiometer. So what do we mean by voltage reference? So let's say I connect plus 5 volts to one of the pin and I connect ground to the other pin. Now as I turn the knob, I should be able to get a voltage from 0 volts to 5 volts at the wiper pin. So by turning the knob, I can provide a voltage reference between this and this value. So instead of ground, if I provide minus 5 volts at this point, I should be able to provide a voltage reference from the range of minus 5 volts to plus 5 volts. So this way, by using all the three pins, potentiometer can be used as a voltage reference. Now let's go ahead and connect this and see how we can provide various voltage levels. Now I'm connecting the wiper pin to the volt pin in the header number 4 so that I can measure the voltage at the wiper pin. And one end of the potentiometer is connected to plus 5 volts. And let me connect the other end of the potentiometer to ground. Now on the Android app, observe the voltage value instead of the resistance. Now as I turn the knob to one end, the voltage has gone almost down to zero. And now I'll start turning the knob to the other end. And now I'm able to increase the voltage until 5 volts. So the Arduino board might not be giving exactly 5 volts. I guess it is around 4.7. So I'm able to reach until 4.7 with this. So again, if I turn the knob back, I should be able to come back to 0 volts. So this way, you can provide a voltage reference using a potentiometer. So for example, let's say I want to provide a voltage reference of 1.8 volts. So I can use a potentiometer and adjust it so that I get around 1.8 volts at the wiper pin. So now instead of the ground pin, let me connect it to minus 5 volts and see how the potentiometer output varies. So instead of connecting to ground, I'm connecting it to V minus in header number 5. Now when I start turning the knob of the potentiometer, you can see how I am getting a negative reference value. Now this negative reference can go down till around 4.5. And again, when I start turning the knob, it goes to the positive range and it goes until 4.7, which is the upper range for this potentiometer. So these are the two most common ways to use a potentiometer. On most of the sensor modules, like the infrared sensor module or any other sensor, you would have seen a potentiometer wherein you can fine tune and adjust the sensitivity of the sensor. So it's nothing but you are providing a reference voltage wherein you can adjust the sensitivity. So when we go ahead and start building the projects, you will get to know exactly how to use the potentiometer and how to provide voltage reference, or even you will come to know how to use the potentiometer as a variable resistor. I hope with this video, you are able to understand how to use a potentiometer as a variable resistor or as a voltage reference. It's important to get a good understanding of all these things so that when you start building projects, you won't have any confusion going ahead. Thank you for watching the video.